threat to the central nervous system. You get a change in motor output. You have a change in motor output. Over time, what happens is that you get tone, which is like an increase in the body's guarding ability. You carry that over and over amount of time, you get spontaneous electrical activity, which that's all over the literature. If you Google scholars search spontaneous electrical activity, you'll get tons of shit on it. So the idea is when the muscles are toned, when it's guarding, you're constantly firing over and over again due to this pain, stress, or threat, we get increased peripheral resistance. So muscle crimps, you're not able to get the blood flow to certain areas, so arteries, the arterioles, all these sort of things aren't able to deliver oxygen to certain tissue. Then we get decreased oxygen, right? So that's hypoxia. You have decreased oxygen for a long amount of time. The body, the brain will tell mRNA, which is messenger RNA, to transcribe Proalpha-1C, which is scar tissue. So under continued hypoxic conditions, we develop scar tissue. So these protective positions, all these sort of things. They all start from, they can start anywhere along that cascade, but they all come from a decreased or hypoxic.